This is an original Sri Lankan poster for the movie Nalangana. From 1960, this scarce poster was in very rough shape, but we gave it a poster fix. We got a movie poster from the country of Sri Lanka. This is a very historical poster as far as the history of Sri Lankan film is concerned. Also, I wasn't really sure that I could restore this poster. It sat in my shop for a year before I figured out how to reline it.
So we got this poster from Sri Lanka. It is a movie poster, and it's in horrible, horrible condition. It's mounted to many, many sheets of something. And the owner wants us to get these sheets off the back of it and restore it. And I don't know if I can get it off. I've already tried solvents and it doesn't seem to respond. So now I'm gonna soak the thing in water and see how it turns out.
Sri Lankan cinema, it is still a fledgling industry that has struggled to find a footing since its inauguration in 1947 with a movie called Karawunu Porondua.
It is face down in a bath. What you're actually seeing, these colors, are paper that's mounted to the back of the poster that I'm trying to remove now. I've been having a hard time removing it. I've tried several different methods, and nothing seemed to make it budge. Finally, I just put it in water, and some of it is coming off, as you can see. And then this is coming off as well. So I'm starting to get more hopeful that I'll be able to save this poster. I'd already told the customer it was unsavable, but I'm beginning to wonder if I can save it.
Sri Lankan films are usually made in the Sinhala language as well as in the Tamil language. In the first 9 years, most films were made in South India and followed the conventions of Indian cinema. Studio shooting was the norm, and with Indian-style sets erected in film studios. It is widely believed that Rakava, made in 1956 by pioneer director Lester James Pearies, was the first Sinhala film to be shot completely out of studio. However, it was the film Gambada Sundan in 1950, which was the first film shot outside studios. It was also the first Sri Lankan film where, like in Rikava, the dialogue was recorded on the spot. I've got all that foreign matter off the poster. The poster's clean, but now it needs to dry. So I'm going to prepare the screen. Actually, I've got some wheat paste from yesterday in this jar, so I'm going to use that. I don't think I need any more than that. The wheat paste gets thick as it sits overnight, so I'm loosening it up with a stir and some water and getting it all mixed up. This is the screen. It's a small size. It can fit 2 one-sheet posters normally or other various sizes. The first thing I do is prepare the screen with this acid-free paper. I gotta get the paper wet. As I apply the wheat paste, the paper is showing signs of expanding. I get movie posters from all over the world, but it's almost never do I get a poster from Sri Lanka. Last year, I linen-backed a few maps of Sri Lanka, printed in the 1940s, for the same customer, a gallery in Sri Lanka. I've actually had this poster over a year and I couldn't figure out how to get the old backing off, so This acid-free paper I use is very nice. It's very resilient, strong. It can be handled well. There are other kinds of paper for linen backing which tear easily when they're wet. This kind I use does not tear as easily. I gotta put an extension on this roller. I'm now rolling out the excessive wheat paste in air pockets to make sure it's flat. I have an excess amount of paper around the outside, so I'm trimming it off. Otherwise, it could cause rippling when it dries. Small red screen is ready to go. We can linen back onto it now. And the poster is dry, and you will see us linen back it after this break. So don't go away. I can't really turn it over to see what it looks like. I don't know what it looks like. Because when I first had it, it had stuff covering the front of it too. So, well, we won't know what this looks like until it gets linen back. This thing is a mess. Let me see how this piece looks. I'm gonna start somewhere. I have to start somewhere. I'm not exactly sure the orientation of this poster, whether it's a vertical or a horizontal format. I'm assuming it's a vertical format. Anyway, now that I've put it down on the wheat paste, I really can't change my mind. I'm committed. At least I should be committed. I'm spraying this with water to help it expand and help it absorb the wheat paste. I have to stretch it out by hand and try to make sure all the pieces are in their correct place. Now that I've put this one sheet down, I'm very committed to the place I put it in. I can't really change it after I put other pieces down. I'm hoping that it'll fit correctly. I'm now gently, with very little pressure, pushing out the excess wheat paste to make the poster stretch out properly and be flat to the paper. Linen backing is a process, as you can see,
where we take an old poster and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. In cases such as this, there's really no choice but to linen back it. But many times, people will linen back posters that are in good condition just to help them flatten and preserve them. This is a difficult poster to roll out because I don't want the paper to move around. Now I'm applying a little bit more pressure than before because I'm finding it's somewhat resistant to flattening out. So I'm pushing it down harder now. And that's about it for this side. Let's slide this back into place. Another thing is I have a tendency to want to dab it rather than to wipe it. I need to get the wheat paste off the face of it, but I'm afraid if I wipe it, it may move around. I'm only going to do a partial wiping right now. I'm not sure if I need to really remove the wheat paste. It may act as a protector on the front.
The movie being advertised on this poster, Nalangana, which means actress. It came out in 1960. It stars one of the most legendary Sri Lankan actresses of all time, Rukmani Devi.
This piece went down kind of easily. I don't know why. I shouldn't say that yet. It'll probably give me problems after I start rolling. I don't want to jinx anything.
The film had the dubious distinction of being the first movie ever banned in the country for obscenity and was called a national disaster by the critics. In today's terms, it wouldn't even be considered PG-13. The movie also had some of the most popular songs from that era, which are still popular today. This poster for Nalangana is important because there are perhaps three people in the world who collect Ceylon Sri Lankan movies, and Nalangana, despite being a terrible movie, it is still considered important for the reasons I've just mentioned. So there are three collectors in the world who collect these kind of things. Furthermore, Rukmani Devi was Ceylon's most legendary actress, sort of the Elizabeth Taylor of Ceylon, who made her mark as a superstar. I don't think there is another poster of this film that has survived. This may be one of a kind.
Bendiya Nisa Giluna Nisa.
As I put these pieces down, they go down dry, and then they're sitting on top of wheat paste. They're beginning to expand. I spray water on them so that they expand. It makes it easier for them to stretch out and to get into place. There's a lot of little rips and tears in here, and because of the very thin and stretchy nature of the paper, I'm never sure if it's really in the proper place. This piece fits right here. That's nice. So it looks like something is coming together right. I can't find an image of this poster online. So we're going to have to do the restoration of it from our imagination and guesswork. And the owner doesn't have a picture of it either, and it must be a very rare poster. I don't really want to wipe it too hard because it may move the paper around, so I tend to just dab it. And that's a good fit. Unfortunately, I don't have the other eye. I was looking online at both Sri Lankan movie posters as well as posters from India, and some of them have a similar graphic style. The way the artwork is done, the types, the beauty standards, and a general stylistic similarity between early Sri Lankan movie posters and Bollywood, although it wasn't called Bollywood then, I don't think. Perhaps I'm wrong.
I still have these bottom pieces over here. I don't know how that bottom is going to look because already the pieces are out of alignment and don't seem to want to move.
The paper is stretching out as I roll it out. I'm also noticing that the paper is stained, but there's nothing I could really do about it. The paper was too fragile to bleach. It risked being further damaged even beyond recognition. So I'm now moving little pieces around and lightly wiping off the gobs of wheat paste. But every time I wipe it off, it moves something out of place. So there we are. I'm concerned about the lower area being lined up right, where the credits are. I've never quite seen paper like this either. It's thin and has a different characteristic than what I'm used to, but it reacts well to absorption. A lot of nitpicking, trying to get these pieces to expand, adding more pieces. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, don't hesitate to send me an email. Tell me the size of the posters. Tell me the approximate date of printing. Let me know if it's an offset printing, silk screen, or if it's a two-sided poster, let me know. I can't linen back most two-sided posters. They don't absorb the wheat paste and therefore don't expand correctly. So send me an email with information. Send me some pictures of your posters, the size and condition, and I'll get back to you with an estimate and recommendations for what we can do to restore it and for what cost. I look forward to seeing your posters. I keep finding little pieces. Unfortunately, I don't have that signature that's there. I only have the top word, art. And I'm doing a final gentle dabbing. And as I do it, I'm making sure the pieces are in correct position. I usually do projects like this on the weekend when it's quieter at the Navy Yard. Makes it easier for me to concentrate.
So that the leak base sort of thins out as it okay, I've brought this to the limit of my linen backing. I'm going to consult with the customer to see how much more they want done to this or whether they want any restoration done at all. There are some problem areas here where things don't exactly line up correctly. However, it could be improved, especially in the faces. I don't have these pieces. I have to recreate them. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
dry for another day before I trim it down.
I love restoring your vintage posters. I appreciate the opportunity and the privilege you give me to handle them. So keep them coming. I will do my best to restore them. Thank you.